When Apollo 11 astronauts landed on the moon, they left a flag on its surface. They spent some time trying to stick it on the lunar surface, and NASA has footage of the event. For instance, this is a proud Buzz Aldrin saluting the American flag erected on the moon. It was July 21, 1969. Each lunar landing was actually marked by the planting of a flag. But apparently flags are not the only things humans have left on the surface of our satellite. There are, for example, a total of 96 bags of human waste on the moon, as well as photos, human ashes, a tiny art gallery, a feather, a hammer, some golf balls, and also rovers and reflectors. These humanity's leftovers will remain on the same piece of moon land forever, unless they get hit by some random asteroid or we decided to return them to Earth to study how time on the moon has affected them. Anyway, some people still claim we've never been on the moon. What will they have to say if they discovered that we are able to directly image the flags on the lunar surface? Would they change their mind? Keep watching the video to get to know more about the most striking proof that we have about the moon landings and more. So make sure to choose a clear sky night. Take your telescope and go out to see if you can spot the American flag on our romantic satellite. Well, bad news, buddy, I'm sorry, but there's no way you'll find what you're looking for. Yes, the flag is still on the moon, but you can't see it using a telescope. And no, it's not because your telescope is too weak. Not even the largest telescopes that we have, like the GTC in Spain, a beast of 10.4 meters in diameter, can do the job. The flag is 125 centimeters long, and you would need an optical wavelength telescope of around 200 meters to see the flag. And it's not even a matter of an obstruction due to the atmosphere. Not even the Hubble Space Telescope would be able to spot the stars and stripes. If we had a telescope 75 meters in diameter, we would be able to resolve the large lunar rover, which has a length of 3.1 meters, but the flag is only 125 centimeters. I'm really sorry. Nothing could be done, unless we launched a telescope to the moon. If we managed to put a telescope in orbit around the moon, and if the Apollo landing really happened, we would then be able to resolve the lunar flag on the surface. Well, guess what? This already was done 14 years ago. See the dark spot in the zoomed square? That's our tiny little cute American flag. This picture was taken by the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, also known as LRO. LRO's primary goal was to make a 3D map of the moon's surface from lunar polar orbit as part of a high-resolution mapping program to identify landing sites and potential resources, investigate the radiation environment, and prove new technologies in anticipation of future automated and human missions to the surface of the moon. On June 23, 2009, the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter entered into orbit around the moon after a 4.5-day journey from the Earth. When launched, the spacecraft was aimed at a point ahead of the moon's position. A mid-course correction was required during the trip in order for the spacecraft to correctly enter the lunar orbit. Once the spacecraft reached the far side of the moon, its rocket motor was fired in order for it to be captured by the moon's gravity into an elliptical lunar orbit. Among other things, LRO managed to send back home some nice pictures of the moon's surface. The astronauts' landing sites were also imaged. Images taken by the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, LRO, have shown that the American flags left on the moon by Apollo astronauts are still standing, except for the Apollo 11 mission, which Buzz Aldrin reported as being knocked over by engine exhaust as Apollo 11 lifted off. But how do we know what we see is the flag's shadow and not a lunar crater? Well, by studying photos of the Apollo landing sites taken at different times during the day, scientists observe shadows circling the points where the flags are thought to be. You can easily find videos on the web that clearly show the shadows circling. Hey you, if you're interested in learning more about the lunar flags, subscribe to our channel. We're about to show you other striking proof of a moon landing. Not everything is about flags, though. At the Apollo 17 site, the tracks laid down by the lunar rover are clearly visible, along with the last foot trails left on the moon. The images also show where the astronauts placed some of the scientific instruments that provided the first insight into the moon's environment and interior. So yeah, we've been to the moon. The lunar landings are real. I mean, we can see the footprints, the flag, the rover. What other proof do we need? Well, maybe we just need more photos. Perhaps we all need a reminder of the kind of sacrifices that went into our journey to the moon. NASA has released all the photos of the 12 Apollo missions that made it to space on a publicly available Flickr photo stream, sorted into a series of incredible albums by mission. Taken right from this gallery, we can see the rising Earth about 5 degrees above the lunar horizon in this telephoto view taken from the Apollo 8 spacecraft. And if the pictures are not enough, we have instruments. Astronauts brought up a large amount of scientific equipment and installed it on the lunar surface during Apollo missions. A number of seismic sensors, scientific experiments, and instruments were sent to the lunar surface in order to measure the environment and provide a clear view of this unprecedented adventure. Until 1977, 5 Apollo mission seismometers continued to successfully transmit data back to the Earth, and the Apollo 11 Lunar Surface Laser Ranging Retro Reflector Array, installed by the astronauts, is still fully functional and measuring the Earth-Moon distance with astonishing precision. Astronomers compute this distance from the round-trip time of laser light pulses traveling at the speed of light, which is reflected back to the Earth by the Moon's surface by 1 or 5 retro reflectors installed on the Moon during the Apollo program. Also, other experiments such as the Solar Wind Composition Experiment, the Lunar Seismic Profiling Experiment, and the Lunar Dust Detector have been gathering data from this distant celestial body, and the results are more than satisfying. I would say the data collected by the experiments is striking proof of the lunar landing. How could we measure seismic activity on the Moon if we didn't leave a seismometer on its surface? So while many were initially skeptical about mankind's ability to reach such a vast and majestic place, it seems that the lunar mission was no hoax or conspiracy. The success of the Apollo program and the data collected by the experiments, as well as beautifully taken images of the landing site, still prove it today. But we also brought back samples and learned a lot about lunar geology from them. I bet you wouldn't think twice if someone asked you to touch, smell, or even lick a sample of lunar soil. Well, scientists make no exception. In the mid-1970s, they were thrilled to finally get their hands on some real lunar rocks. After decades of studying the Moon through telescopes, the Apollo mission had finally reached its destination and collected enough information to make groundbreaking discoveries. But the real prize was the lunar rocks that the crew retrieved from the surface of the Moon. They immediately set about analyzing them to learn about the physical properties of the Moon. The results were astonishing. Analysis of the rock samples revealed the presence of oxygen, silicon, and iron, as well as several other elements impossible to detect from Earth-bound telescopes. This gave scientists a better understanding of the composition of the Moon's surface. I'm sure the analysis wasn't without its own comedic moments. If I were a scientist, you would find me chewing on a piece of lunar rock because I'd probably be dying to see how it tastes. Anyway, since then, lunar rock sample analysis has become an integral part of understanding the formation and evolution of our Moon. But one thing is still true. Whenever I'll find a discussion about the lunar samples, I will always be thinking of tasting the delicious lunar soil. The survivals of the Apollo missions on the lunar surface, from flags and footpaths to scientific experiments, photographs, and samples, have provided us with an abundance of proof of mankind's ability to reach the Moon. Today, the evidence of these missions can still be seen and analyzed on the Moon's surface, providing a continual reminder of the courage and feats of the space pioneers, and reminding us of the countless contributions made by the Apollo space program. Even if you can't see the flag with a telescope, the Apollo missions remain living proof that when we come together, nothing is impossible. Thanks for watching the video. What would you like to hear next? Let us know in the comments below. I'll see you next time on the channel.